talk to children. I mean, one of the most important things that parents can do with children is talk to them in order to build their vocabulary. They can talk to them about what they're doing. They can talk to them about what they're thinking. They can talk to them about what they're watching on television. They can talk to them about their past experiences, their future experiences. And that just provides children with the opportunity to both hear and practice their own vocabulary knowledge. Of course, other opportunities are reading to and with children so that children can hear that beautiful language in books and the interesting words in books. They can play word games with children, rhyming games, lots of word play, positive reinforcement for using big words. So when children come up with a really big word, really praise that so that they understand that it's a good thing to use big words and to show off using big words. So these are all very practical ways that parents can make kids, can get kids interested in word learning. Books offer a great opportunity for kids to hear, to read interesting words that are more sophisticated than they might hear in their everyday life. So whereas a parent might use words like talk or speak in their everyday conversation with kids, books might have words like communicate, discuss, that are a little bit more advanced, and children have the opportunity to experience these words in rich context in books. So books have beautiful illustrations, wonderful content that really bring those words to life and allow children to learn words that are interesting and fun. One of the phenomena we know happens with kids is often kids learn to read with relative ease, though some kids struggle. Many children learn to read with relative ease, but when they get to about third, fourth grade, they might not be performing as well in the area of reading. We call that the fourth grade slump. And what happens is children are doing fine with reading text, but they're not understanding what they read. They're not able to use the vocabulary and the content and make meaning from the text. So what we hope to do is build a really solid foundation of early vocabulary knowledge so that when children get to that point in school, they understand a little bit better what it is that they're reading and can learn from the books that they're reading in school. There's been a lot of research done over the past couple of decades that have shown that children from different backgrounds have different opportunities to learn words. And especially children from low socioeconomic backgrounds or English language learning backgrounds, they may not have as rich of a language environment, an English language environment, as other children. And so they come to school having limited vocabulary knowledge as compared to their peers. So it's estimated that the gap could be anywhere from 20,000 words for the kids who have more advanced vocabulary knowledge to 5,000 words for children who have more limited vocabulary knowledge upon entering first grade. So the gap is really a 15,000 word gap if estimates play out correctly. And so the issue with that is that children have different opportunities to learn more words from texts depending on the amount of text that they understand already. And so what we hope to do is provide children with a very rich language background very early so that they can catch up to their peers and start with an even playing field. And it's not that children come to school lacking background knowledge. They have different experiences that may not necessarily represent the academic language that we value in schools. So we want to give children that academic language, those advanced vocabulary words that they might be experiencing in school, but we also want to, of course, value their home language and value the experiences that they do bring to school and build on those so that they can make that connection between home and school and their prior experience and their new experiences in school. Some of the most effective ways for reducing the vocabulary gap have to do with explicit vocabulary instruction in school. And so teachers can take the opportunity to find words in books that they're reading to children or opportunities in activities that they're doing with children to highlight advanced or sophisticated vocabulary words. Define those words explicitly for kids in kid-friendly language so that they understand what that word means in language that they can comprehend. Give them lots of opportunities to hear that word in many different contexts, to use that word themselves, to act out the word, to illustrate the word so that they can get those visual and kinesthetic connections to their word learning. And really explicitly and systematically focus on vocabulary as an important content area, just like they would with teaching the letters and sounds. So really thinking through what words are important for kids to know and how can I share the information about words in a very clear and explicit way so that kids can understand it as easily as possible. Television can provide a great complement to what parents and teachers are doing, both at home and in the classroom, because especially educational television has interesting contexts that can introduce words to kids, and it also has the wonderful feature of having visuals, action, music to highlight words and help define words. It makes words a little bit more concrete for kids, especially for kids who have limited background knowledge, so maybe kids from low-income backgrounds or English language learners. The multimedia context of television can bring those words to life. So it's not obviously a replacement for talking to kids or reading books with kids, but it's a great way to complement what parents are already doing. Because many children come from environments where they may not have a lot of exposure to really advanced and sophisticated words, what we want to do is create an environment on television where kids can experience lots of rich and interesting words, hear them over and over again, and supportive contexts that are fun and engaging, so that kids, when they're watching television, have the opportunity to learn from that television, and then hopefully use those words that they learn in their everyday experiences at home and in school as well. So the television programs have a real potential to show kids, both through video, through audio, through the multimedia dimensions of television, what words mean, how words work in different contexts. And multimedia has a lot of affordances that children may not necessarily have if they're not able to read books yet on their own, if their parents are not able to read to them often or frequently. So the multimedia gives a context for children to learn words where they might not necessarily hear those rich words in everyday conversation. Well, there's a foundation of research that comes from shows like Sesame Street and Arthur and Between the Lines that shows that kids who watch these programs do learn vocabulary words from them. And what I've done in the past is actually shown children video in conjunction with books that they're reading. And that's shown that my research in that area has shown that children are learning words from the books, but they're learning words their word learning is being reinforced by the video, by the television programs that we're showing in conjunction with the books. So when I say that that vocabulary learning is complemented by using television, we do have research to show that children who are exposed to video can use both the nonverbal and the verbal information from text to build their vocabulary in a way that maybe they don't necessarily have access to in a book reading experience. So I encourage teachers to work with books and reinforce the vocabulary learning through television programs or video. In my own research, I was using science textbooks, science books, both fiction and nonfiction books, and having children watch National Geographic shows, reinforcing the words that they were learning in the books. And we found that especially English language learners were learning more from the context of having the book and the video, because they got to have that verbal and that nonverbal information to support their word learning, especially when they're still learning maybe perhaps the basic words that they need to build a foundation of more advanced word knowledge. Both narrative, non-narrative, they're all opportunities for teaching children rich words, especially considering that a lot of what they're going to be doing in school is reading both narrative and non-narrative text. So exposure to all of those different opportunities to learn words can be really important for children. The educational goal of Martha Speaks is vocabulary, and of course that's one of the major components of literacy that we're focusing on across the nation, because we understand it's such an important foundation for kids. And the way that we infuse vocabulary into Martha is that we have all the characters in Martha asking about words and getting excited about words. So throughout the show, it's not just Martha who learns words, but other kids in the show will ask about what a word might mean, or they'll get confused about a word and somebody else has to explain it to them. So what we do in Martha is we have five words that are a little bit more advanced that children can be exposed to, and we give them explicit definitions of those more advanced words. Then we also have a lot of more basic words that we infuse throughout the program that are just more implicitly supported through the visuals and the music and the narrative in the show. And so we're giving kids probably 10 words per episode, 10 words per show, and then we repeat those words several times throughout the show because we know from research that kids need probably anywhere from 20, 30, 40 exposures to words before that they can build their word knowledge. So throughout Martha, we repeat the words, we cycle the words throughout the show so that not just in one episode, but in multiple episodes, we repeat the words and reinforce the words that we've been teaching in other episodes. We make word learning appear fun, look fun, so that kids can really use the characters in the show as a model for their word learning. So with Martha, we're doing research on the actual effect of the program, so to the extent to which children learn words from watching the show. We're also doing research on how teachers can use Martha in classrooms. So we're working on a reading buddies program where older kids and younger kids watch the show together, and then the older buddies help the younger buddies learn the words. So we're using that as a way to help teachers use Martha and the resources from Martha in the classroom.